Welcome. In this video, we will see how to use checkbox in MATLAB GUI. So for that, we have to open guide. So here we have to click on this blank GUI, click on OK. So this is the layout for building the GUI. Now here we have different components. So out of that, I will choose here the checkbox. Okay. So I have to just click it, drag it and drop it on this layout. Okay. Then here, what I'm going to do in this demo is that I'm going to have a checkbox, just like in most of the softwares or some forms that we are submitting online, we have a final checkbox to agree that you have read the terms and conditions. Okay. So similar kind of GUI I am going to create in this video. Okay, so here I am having that checkbox and I will have one submit button. Okay, so this is a push button that I will be using as a submit button. Okay, so I will just save this first of all. So I have to click on save and give some name to this file. Okay, for example, demo checkbox. So once I save that figure window, then I will get this .m file for the GUI. Okay, so I will again switch over to the figure. Okay, so here this checkbox, I can double click on this and I can go to the property inspector of that checkbox. So for this checkbox, we have to modify the string. Okay, so here I can write the string in front of that checkbox. For example, I agree the terms and conditions. Okay. In most of the cases, you have such kind of statement at the end. Okay, so I will use this as a string. Okay, you can use any other statement. Then for this tag, I'm going to give the name as I agree. So I've given the tag name as I agree checkbox. Then I will just increase the font size. Let it be 14. Now I will close this. Okay. So this is that checkbox. Okay. Now this is a push button. Again, I will double click on this and edit the properties of this push button. So here I'm going to go to again string. Okay. And get the name as submit. And here also I will give the tag name as submit button. I will also increase the font 14. So this is our submit button. Okay. Now, whenever I click on this submit, the GUI or this form will get submitted. Okay. And the window will close. But if suppose I have not checked this checkbox, then at that time, if I try to submit, then I should get an error. Generally, a small error is displayed in red letters here that click on the checkbox and then click on submit, right? So I will also do similar kind of arrangement for this GUI. So for that, I'm going to take this static text box. Okay, so I'll just drag it and drop it here. And now I will go to this properties of that. And in the string section, I have to type what error should be displayed if the checkbox is not checked and the user clicks on submit button, right? So the error will be, let us say, click on the checkbox and then click the submit button. Okay, so this is the text that will be displayed if error is there. Okay, then I will give name to this as, let's say, err, that is error. And let the font be 8, and I can modify the color of the text. Okay, so for that I can use this foreground color. Okay, and generally it is displayed in red color, so I will select the red and I'll click on OK, and now I can close this. But this error should not be visible if the user checks this box and then clicks on submit button, right? And the other thing is, whenever user clicks on this checkbox and clicks on submit, this window should get closed and you should get a message that you have successfully submitted the form or the GUI. Okay, so that is the task that I want to perform. So now let us begin programming this GUI. So this is the arrangement. So now I can go to this submit callback. So right click on submit button, go to view callbacks and callback. So this is the callback function. Whenever I click the button, it will come to this function, right? So here I will have to find out the status of the checkbox. So to get the status of checkbox, we have a command. Let us say s is equal to get handles dot. Now I have to give here the tag name of the checkbox. So you can click on this checkbox and you can see here the tag name. Okay, so the tag name is I agree checkbox. So I can type that tag name over here, I agree checkbox. So that is the tag name. Now I want to get the value of that checkbox, whether that checkbox is checked or not checked. Okay, so to get that, I can give here comma and in single inverted quotes value. Now this value will return a value or result as 1 if the checkbox is checked, and if it will return value 0 if the checkbox is not checked. Okay, now using this I can decide whether to display the error or not, right? Okay, so here I can use switch and I can use s. So case, if the case is 0, it means that the checkbox is not checked and I have clicked on submit button, then I should get the error, right? So to display that error, I have to just make that text box, static text box visible, right? So I can do that with the command set handles dot. I have to type here the tag name for that static text box, that is err, comma. And now here I can make it visible or invisible, right? So visible, comma, again in single inverted quotes, on. So that static text box will be visible and it will display the error. But now if the checkbox is checked, then I will get 1 as the output of the statement, or 1 will be there in the s variable. Now here I have to display the message, right? So I have to display a message box which can be called using a command, message box in single inverted quotes, submitted successfully. Okay, so I can type that as a message, right? And now I want to close the background window. Okay, so for that again I have to give here command close and the name of the window or name of your GUI. Okay, so that is here in this case demo checkbox and end. Okay, so now this is the program. So let us check how it works. So I can click on this. So now you will see this error message already displayed over here, right? Initially this message should not be displayed, right? So for that, one correction I have to make. So let me close this. So whenever I run that GUI, at that time the first file that executes is this, the function that executes is this one, opening function. So here I have to hide that error message, right? So I can use the command set handles dot err, comma, visible, comma, off. Now I can run it. You can see that the error message is not visible, right? So if I click on submit, I get the error message, right? But if I click on checkbox and then click on submit, then that window closes and I get a message as submitted successfully. Okay, so this is how I can use the checkbox in GUI for different type of applications. Thank you.